kembaliinnya.
Ditutup dulu, bahasanya pengurus.
Selamat pagi, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Halo.
Selamat pagi.
Pagi chef.
Hari chef. Ini pertemuan hari ini yaitu ini ya untuk pengenalan breakfast menu ya, tapi masakan Chinese ya. Dan hari ini kita kedatangan dari chef dari Sukanda ya. Sukanda itu produk FB ya. Jadi hari ini ketemu dengan Chef Andri dan Aldi, Chef Aldi. Ya. Nanti habis ini ada presentasi tentang produk-produknya ya. Produk-produknya setelah PPT produk, kemudian nanti dilanjutkan dengan demo masak ya, terutama untuk breakfast-nya Chinese ya. Baik, silakan Bu kalau mau untuk.
Halo.
Halo.
Hello everybody. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, Chef.
How are you all today? All good?
Good.
Good.
Yes.
All right, brilliant. So, let me introduce ourselves. My name is Chef Okta, and beside me is Chef Aldi. Hello to you all, and we are from Sukanda Jaya. You know, we are from Cibitung, and one of the biggest food and beverage distribution in Indonesia. And today we are proudly present the brand of Lee Kam Kee. And you know, as a Lee Kam Kee product is very well known in the world, you know. And we have a lot of variety of products that we brought here today. So from the beginning, what do you know about Lee Kam Kee?
Nah, teman-teman semuanya yang di rumah, sebelumnya perkenalkan kami berdua dari PT Sukanda Jaya, di mana PT Sukanda Jaya adalah importir dan distribusi terbesar di Indonesia. Dan salah satu brand yang ada di PT Sukanda Jaya yaitu adalah Lee Kam Kee. Lee Kam Kee sendiri adalah saus tiram terbaik dan terbesar di dunia. Mengeluarkan saus tiram pertama. Nah, Lee Kam Kee Indonesia ini mempunyai beberapa varian ya, Chef ya?
Yes.
Lee Kam Kee has much variation of the sauce, Chef ya?
Yes, definitely.
We have start from the soy sauce, oyster, absolutely. And we have convenience sauce. Nah, Lee Kam Kee sendiri mempunyai beberapa varian saus ya, teman-teman. Mungkin teman-teman udah sering melihat di supermarket atau di tempat-tempat perbelanjaan lainnya. Nah, di situ banyak di display saus-saus Lee Kam Kee variasinya. What's the variety of the Lee Kam Kee, sir?
Okay, basically, we have oyster sauce as a mother sauce of the Chinese cuisine, especially. We also have a soy sauce.
Soy sauce.
The soy sauce also has a different variety also.
Yeah.
One is the premium.
Premium
and
sauce.
And then the casual soy sauce,
yeah.
And then we have sesame oil, dark soy. We also have.
Nah, teman-teman, di sini right. Kita juga ada variasi-variasinya. Nah, dari oyster atau saus itu sendiri, kita mempunyai yang premium oyster sauce ya, Chef, ya? We have a premium oyster sauce. And also yang common atau biasa kita lihat adalah saus tiram cap panda.
Also we have a premium oyster sauce.
Premium oyster sauce. Yeah. And we have four type of soy sauce ya, Chef, ya?
Yeah.
Casual atau yang soy sauce yang biasa, yang warna merah. Nah, kita punya yang premium juga, premium soy sauce. We have a dark soy sauce.
Yeah.
Nah, itu yang lebih hitam. Nah, dan kita punya juga minyak wijen. Nah, gitu.
Yeah. And we also have another variety. Is for example, this one is for fish marinade.
Nah, ini
this one is seasoned for seafood. It's easy to be applied in the seafood base.
Yeah.
Just normally we use it as a
steam fish. Ya. Nah, biasanya teman-teman di sini seasoned for seafood ini tergolong dalam kategori soy sauce juga, siapa ya?
Soy sauce juga.
Nah, soy sauce and biasanya digunakan untuk makanan steam fish atau steam seafood lainnya. And also, Chef, we have a manufacturing plants.
Yeah. Actually, Lee Kamki, the birth of Lee Kamki is in 1888.
Yeah,
1888. Yeah, and then established in Hong Kong. And then we have actually big manufacturer in the world, two in China, one in Hong Kong, one in USA, one in Malaysia.
Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur.
Yeah.
Nah, di sini teman-teman kita mempunyai beberapa pabrik produksi, di antaranya kita mempunyai ada di US, ada di Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur, ada di China, ada di Hong Kong juga.
Yeah.
Gitu ya, Chef, ya?
Yeah, two plants in China.
Two plants in China, oke. Okay. Yeah. Dan teman-teman, Lee Kamki ini mempunyai fish tadi yang saya bilang ada beberapa macam saus. We have a type of sauce, Chef, ya?
Yes.
We have like seven or Chef, ya? Seven
type
of sauce.
Yes. We have a different type of sauces. I mean, different varieties in here.
Duh.
One is oyster sauce base.
Soy sauce base.
And then we have a soy sauce base.
Soy sauce base.
Cooking ingredients such as sesame oil. And then we have a convenience sauce. Like example here. Barbecue, hoisin,
plum
sauce,
black pepper,
and then fine shrimp, and then we have oriented sauce. Nah, like example in here,
MOS,
this one one of the example, the soup base for chicken hot pot.
Nah, teman-teman di rumah kalau misalkan suka memasak sup ala Chinese, nah di sini di Kamki mempermudah teman-teman dengan mempunyai we have a sachet size ya, Chef?
Yes.
Yeah, you can use this.
This all comes up for as a sachet base. Sachet.
Okay. Next, the next, Chef, we have
dressing and also gourmet. The dressing gourmet. One is what we have now is Japanese dressing and Vietnamese dressing. And then we have the XO sauce, the most delicious one. Yeah. XO sauce and it's very expensive as
very
well.
Expensive also.
Yeah, but the taste is very good. Yeah.
Nah, teman-teman di sini bisa melihat variasi produk kita. Nah, itu ada salad dressing di mana kita mau tidak hanya melulu tentang Chinese sauce, kita juga ada Japanese dressing dan Vietnamese. Nah, terus yang tadi Chef Okta bilang itu ada the tasty sauce, we have a gourmet XO sauce, itu rasanya sangat enak. Tapi ya the price is most expensive, Chef, ya?
Yeah. But worth to taste, you know.
Okay.
Okay. By the way, you also can find in a lot of different shop in Indonesia, especially.
Yeah.
You can find in the mini market. Or wet market, traditional market, supermarket, and then
we are supplied to the Horeca. We call it Horeca, isn't it?
Horeca, yeah. Yes.
Hotel, correct. Restaurant, and catering.
Yeah. Okay. We also come with a size of food service.
Yeah.
Each packaging is quite, I think, 1.8 to 2 up to 2 kilos.
2 kilos. Nah, yeah. Berarti teman-teman di sini yang mungkin ada mau buka usaha dan memakai saus-saus Likamki tersendiri mempunyai produk range atau ukuran yang untuk food service ya, atau ukuran bulky yang sangat besar. Di situ juga ada tipe-tipenya teman-teman ya. Ada saus plum, hoisin, ada wijen, barbecue, lada hitam, dan juga ada soy sauce. This is for the big size. Okay, the next. Okay.
What we have today for cooking?
Yeah.
We're gonna cook three different breakfast today. One is siomai. Second one is dumpling. Or call it
xiao qi.
Yeah. Okay. Third one is fengzhao.
Fengzhao.
Or you get chicken feet. Yeah.
Yeah. And also we using the Likamki three type of essential sauce. Yeah.
Everything we have today, we use Likamki product. From oyster sauce to condiment sauce, we all use it together. Yeah,
we combine the
very easy.
Yeah. Potential and essential sauce.
One thing, you don't need to put a salt or you don't need to put any more MSG inside your cooking. So you only use this kind of product, this kind of sauce, you can make a very delicious dish.
Yeah, because the oyster also already have a
tasty taste, their own natural MSG.
Yeah, because from the
not
oyster.
Added MSG, okay, but okay. Natural MSG.
Nah, teman-teman,
it comes from the oyster itself, Because every protein actually they have a contains a MSG.
MSG.
For example, if you boil a chicken,
we
the
have
whole
a,
chicken,
yeah,
without adding the salt, you can taste the saltiness actually, very light.
Yeah, the chicken outing the juicy from the his body.
Yes,
yeah?
The fat, the nutrition, the all everything it comes out from the protein.
Yeah,
so you don't need to put then this one the oyster, instead of making the your food is smelly, but not is get is make your food is actually taste nicer and smell nicer.
Okay.
The original taste of the product it will come out naturally.
Nah, teman-teman di sini tadi Chef Okta bilang bahwa teman-teman jika memasak menggunakan produk Likamki itu sudah tidak perlu menambahkan lada, maksud saya garam atau MSG lainnya. Nah, karena Likamki sendiri ini sudah mempunyai rasa yang gurih yang alami dari proses ekstrak tiram tersebut. Nah, jadi teman-teman, contohnya kalau teman-teman memasak stok dari ikan atau ayam, nah itu dapat dari jus si daging itu sendiri. Jadi no need to adding the MSG or something salt.
Not at all.
Okay. So the is enough for extending this Likamki, Chef?
Let's begin for the
first dish. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
First dish is we are making a fengzhao.
Fengzhao atau steam chicken feet.
Okay.
What type of sauce we gonna use?
Okay. The first one with the barbecue sauce, and then a little bit of hoisin sauce,
and then
sesame oil, and then you can either use premium or panda.
You can use both of them. Nah, di sini
what's the difference of this? This is the same oyster, but the premium one contains more oyster.
Okay.
So it extracts more oyster inside it. This one, less oyster. Okay. But the taste is damn good, you know. But this one is more. For example, if you cook a one dish, you use the panda oyster, you need to put two teaspoons. And this one, you only put one teaspoon.
One teaspoon.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it. That's the difference.
Teman-teman di
we
sini
also use the premium oyster sauce.
Okay.
Premium soy sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
Teman-teman di sini tadi sudah dijelaskan ada perbedaan di antara premium dengan saus tiram yang capanda. Itu adalah Kalau yang premium sudah ada ekstrak tiramnya lebih banyak ketimbang si cap pandanya. Jadi kalau misalkan teman-teman menggunakan saus tiram yang premium itu cukup menggunakan 1 sendok teh atau 1 sendok makan dari quantity yang ada di saus tiram yang premium lah. Jika teman-teman menggunakan saus tiram yang panda itu harus lebih banyak, bisa menggunakan 2 sendok teh atau 2 sendok makan saus tiram cap panda. Nah, gitu. So chef, besides the chicken feet, what this we can use from the barbecue?
Barbecue.
What kind of this you can use the and hoisins also.
Like a title, like its title, you know, it's a barbecue. So anything to do with the barbecuing, you can use the barbecue sauce as your sauce.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you also can combine with a lot of different varieties of the likangki sauces. Mm. For example, you can combine with the hoisin.
Yes.
Yeah, hoisin and this one combined together, then it makes a really good taste. Yeah.
Good taste. Yeah.
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 And then remember, if you combine different varieties of likangki sauces, remember to adjust the saltiness balance.
Yeah.
You know, because the soy sauce is already salty, and then the oyster sauce is already salty, and then this one also have a saltiness as well.
Inside, yeah.
So you have to really balance the flavor, especially if you put more than 4 or 5 different sauces in here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, if you want to balance the saltiness, you can use the plum here, because it has a sweetness and then the sourness as well.
Yeah. So if you're not using the sugar, the plum will be
This actually is a good idea. Without adding a sugar, you only use plum as a balance to balancing the flavor.
Yeah, plum flavor, balancing the flavor. Okay.
Hmm. Plum sauce. It's a good thing, you know. You can just fried chicken maybe or duck breast.
It's more dipping.
Just dipping with the
spring roll.
Spring roll as well. Spring roll as well. Of course.
It's good.
It's good.
Nah, teman-teman di sini. Harus diperhatikan ya bagaimana nanti menggunakan tata cara saus, karena kita menggunakan banyak variety saus dari Likangki. Nah, saltiness-nya harus diperhatikan karena di setiap saus sudah ada masing-masing rasa yang gurih dan asinnya. Jadi teman-teman di sini harus membalance-kan gimana rasanya biar bisa enak dan taste good. Nah, makanya nanti penggunaannya jangan terlalu banyak gitu. Oke, chef.
Alright, let's begin to cook
our first dish.
Before we start cooking, maybe you can show the videos of the history of Likangki.
Oh, maybe. We have a video.
Yes, we have a short video. Okay, very interesting, you know.
It's very interesting.
Okay.
Maybe teman-teman bisa melihat di rumah video sekilas tentang background Likangki. Bagaimana Likangki itu dibuat, bagaimana Likangki itu diproduksi, Chef ya?
Yes.
Okay. Teman-teman, kita lagi prepare. Nanti teman-teman juga bisa mencatat bahan-bahan apa saja serta step-step apa saja yang digunakan oleh kami berdua dalam mengolah chicken feet, siomay atau nanti dumpling gitu. Teman-teman jangan lupa disiapkan catatannya, nah gitu ya. Oke. Dan teman-teman juga jangan lupa mungkin bisa menjumpai saus-saus Likangki ini dengan varieti rasa di e-commerce yang teman-teman punya di HP teman-teman masing-masing. Oke, video sudah bisa diputar. Nah, teman-teman bisa melihat ya.
Our story begins in 1888 when Lee Kung Shum accidentally overcooked his oyster soup, creating the first taste of our iconic oyster sauce and beginning a century-long journey of flavor. With the birth of Wing Chun's first grandmaster, we rose to fame during a legendary era. In 1921, the polygraph was invented.
Is this sauce made with fresh oysters?
Of course. There could be no doubt that Mr. Lee only used fresh oysters in his sauces. To ensure his standards remain firmly adhered to, we manage our own oyster farms, growing each oyster while closely monitoring growth and water quality around the clock.
During the Roaring Twenties, a film company introduced a roaring lion as its mascot. Not to be outdone, we created our own icons, our famous Boat Lady and Boat Boy. In 1972, China gifted Ling Ling and Xing Xing to the United States, introducing the world to panda diplomacy. Inspired by this gesture, we launched our panda brand oyster sauce, which would go on to become a bestseller around the world. By the 80s, home computers had entered the mainstream. Yeah. Technology burst into our lives. Our time-honored traditions didn't stop us from innovating. We switched to steam generators and modernized every stage of the production process. Lately, we've been investing in the most advanced European-designed facilities to ensure we will always bring you the best from farm to fork. As the world's population soared past 5 billion in 1987, we worked even harder to ensure that wherever there are people, there is always Lee Kum Kee. Our determination to bring you the best taste experience is why we continuously innovate with new products and packaging. In 2003, China successfully launched its first manned spaceflight. It wasn't long before China's fourth manned spaceflight, Shenzhou 9, took Lee Kum Kee into space. Why aim for world class when you can be space class? By the time the Rio Olympics rolled around in 2016, records were being broken everywhere. We cemented our place as the world's number one oyster sauce brand for 11 consecutive years. No matter how much the world changes, the superb taste and quality of our oyster sauces will always remain the same.
Nah, teman-teman sudah melihat ya videonya, singkatnya bagaimana saus tiram Lee Kum Kee itu ditemukan. Next.
Okay, let's begin to the video,
Yeah.
First, we prepare the chicken feet, the fresh chicken feet. You can buy from the
supermarket. Or traditional market, you can buy the chicken feet over there. Okay.
Yeah, chicken feet, the broiler one,
Yeah, the broiler one.
Okay. The claws have to be removed.
We already cleaned the cloth and the...
The claws, yeah.
Yeah.
And then we clean, and then first we deep fry. We fry in a very
hot deep,
hot oil. Yeah, over here. Maybe the cameraman can move over here.
So, chef, what the function we fry the chicken feet first?
Okay.
You can explain to the audience.
Yeah, first I want to make it soft.
Soft.
Yeah. Yeah. But the skin of the feet is very thick to the bones. Yeah.
Okay.
Then I want to make it a little bit loose. Yeah, little bit loose from the skin, and then we by frying. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we soak in the water.
And
we
vinegar.
Add a little bit of vinegar.
Vinegar.
Rest for another 30 minutes.
30 minutes.
Then it will become very, very soggy and fluffy.
And for vinegar, we using the...
The Lee Kum Kee vinegar. Yes, of course.
Lee Kum Kee have vinegar also.
Okay.
And we're looking for the crispiness of from the chicken feet.
Sorry?
We're looking for the crispiness from the chicken feet.
Not the crispiness.
Just I mean, for the...
For the...
From texture,
the form of the texture. You know, I want to... Because the skin and the bones is actually very stick together.
Okay.
Yeah. If you just deep fry like that or just boil like that, it'll become, it's quite hard to chew.
Yeah.
Okay. So I want to lose it.
Okay.
I want to lose the skin from the bone.
Mm.
So I deep fry and then I soak in the water with vinegar.
Vinegar.
Yeah.
Nah, buat teman-teman di rumah, di sini sudah dijelaskan tips and trick bagaimana chicken feet itu bisa melunak. Nah, dengan proses digoreng seperti ini dengan minyak yang banyak, chicken feet akan mudah mengurangi ke rasa keras dari si daging dari ceker tersebut. Nah, makanya teman-teman step pertama itu nanti digoreng sampai dia agak mengembang sedikit. Nah, nanti direndam atau disoaking di dalam air dan cuka. Cukanya tentu dari Likamki. Nanti disoaking selama 30 menit ya, Chef?
Iya.
30 menit. Nah, selama 30 menit. Didiamkan agar si tekstur dari ceker atau chicken feet-nya lebih lunak. Gitu. And also for the sauce, we using the hoisin and the barbecue.
Yeah, the sauce, we using the barbecue and then the hoisin, oyster panda,
and
a little bit soy sauce,
premium soy sauce,
and then sesame oil.
Sesame oil.
Yeah, remember this one. Oh yeah, the chicken feet, the recipe says it's 500 grams.
500 grams.
Yeah, actually I prepared 500 gram, but this one I divide by 2.
Oh iya.
So the recipe has to be half of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nah, teman-teman siapkan catatannya. Mungkin ada yang tertarik untuk membuatnya di rumah. Siapkan kertas dan pulpennya biar langsung dicatat apa yang kita lakukan, step-stepnya, bahan-bahannya.
The chicken feet is 500 gram.
Yes.
The water is 1/2 liter.
Water for the soaking the chicken feet, yes.
After and vinegar is about 5 tablespoon.
5 tablespoon of vinegar, okay. Nah, teman-teman, disitu nanti bisa dijelaskan kalau airnya itu sekitar 500 mili. Nah, dan kadar dari cukanya tersebut cukup 5 sendok makan biar nanti rasanya tidak terlalu asam ya. Nah, itu hanya untuk melunakan. Ini kita tinggal lagi menunggu minyaknya panas. Nanti setelah panas, ayamnya atau chicken feet-nya akan segera goreng.
Oke.
Okay. Already hot, Chef?
Iya. Yeah.
Oke. Okay. Nah, ini agak sedikit meletup-meletup ya, teman-teman. Hati-hati jika menggoreng ceker. Karena dia konten airnya cukup ada banyak. Mungkin teman-teman nanti bisa menutupnya agar tidak muncat kemana-mana ya si minyaknya gitu. Nah, teman-teman kalau mau membeli Likamki atau mau memakai produk Likamki ini sudah ada di pasaran teman-teman ya. Sudah di traditional market, ada di supermarket, dan juga ada di e-commerce. Nah, kalau Sukanda Jaya sendiri mempunyai e-commerce ada di Tokopedia dan Blibli. Nah, itu ada Sukanda Jaya Home dan Sukanda Jaya Kitchen. Nah, teman-teman bisa membeli produk Likamki di e-commerce tersebut gitu. Nanti kalau mungkin ada promo bisa dilihat-lihat ya teman-teman ya. Oke, okay. So the chef preparing the water and the vinegar also in bowl. Ya. Yeah. Bisa lihat teman-teman ini air yang kurang lebih 500 mili.
Nah. Yeah. More or less ya. Yeah. Depends of the quantity of the. This one is for 500 gram. It's enough for the 500 milliliter. Okay.
So.
Some run.
5 tablespoon.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah. Then stir. The water and vinegar for the perfect combine. You can show the Likamki vinegar to the camera.
Ah, yeah, this one.
If people want to know, yeah.
It's already available. Like. Yeah, it's maybe some of you is not familiar with this product, but actually you can find in the large market. Yeah,
large like market.
Ranch or hypermart or something like very very big store.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oke. Okay. Nah, teman-teman, di sini dimsum sendiri biasanya itu bisa dibilang adalah makanan small portion ya, Chef.
Iya.
Small portion ya. Biasa ada ditempatkan di seperti basket dimsum seperti ini. Nah, biasanya tuh variasi dimsum enggak cuma hanya 3 yang kita masak sekarang. Bisa aja ada guabau, ada lain-lainnya.
Ada nah, lomaikai.
Lomaikai, ya siap ya? Banyak banget. Nah,
spring
makanya
roll.
Ya ada spring roll juga. Mungkin teman-teman sudah pernah makan di tempat-tempat dimsum favorit teman-teman di rumah. Nah, yeah. Di sini kita only cook 3 type of this dimsum. Nah.
Fun fact about dimsum. Dimsum actually is very popular in Asia.
Asia.
Not only in China or Hong Kong, but basically in China or Hong Kong, dimsum will be eaten in the morning as a breakfast. Not in the evening, not in the afternoon, but basically dimsum they usually eat in the morning. The companion itself can be with noodles or porridge or maybe a fried rice, jasmine tea, oolong tea, or they seldom drink coffee in the morning. But normally elder people in China, they eat dim sum with oolong tea.
Oolong tea.
Or you can call it a yamcha.
Yamcha.
Yeah. Very popular terms in Chinese. Yamcha.
Yamcha.
And then dim sum also not only popular in China or Hong Kong. They spread out within the Asia, especially in Vietnam, Thailand.
Include Indonesia also.
Indonesia, right? Of course, Malaysia, Singapore. They're very popular, you know, and even dim sum is now a very attractive dish. You can combine with any, or you can fuse with any other style of cuisine. Maybe, or you can call it shumai, brulee, or whatever.
Yeah.
You can fuse it with the Western style.
Confusion with the Western or the Japanese style.
Or even you can find it on the street, you know.
On the street.
Yeah.
Banyak dijumpai di kawasan-kawasan Asia tentunya, bagaimana dimsum itu sudah populer, termasuk di Indonesia juga banyak kita jumpai dimsum-dimsum, bisa jadi street food atau mungkin jajanan-jajanan. Nah biasanya, Chef Okta said, dimsum ini adalah biasanya dimakan ketika waktu breakfast atau makan pagi ya Chef ya. Nah bisa juga di compare atau di kombinasikan dengan makanan-makanan seperti nasi goreng, bakmi, mie, atau mungkin bubur sekalipun. Nah, jadi teman-teman di sini bisa mengetahui bagaimana dimsum itu jam makannya kapan atau bisa dikonsumsi lebih tepatnya kapan. Nah, gitu. Oke. Okay. While we waiting the chicken feet cook, we prepare the other ingredients. Nah, we have a ginger atau jahe biasanya di sini. Ada cabai merah besar, ada daun kucai. Nah, ini adalah bahan-bahan untuk nanti membuat chicken feet-nya.
Oke. Okay. Garlic, sorry.
Garlic ya, chop garlic.
Ada chop garlic.
So chef, this is the other ingredients for the sauce, chef ya, beside the
liquid sauce. Yeah, it's a complementary to the sauce. Yeah. Yeah,
okay.
We add in the chili to enhance the flavor of the chili, you know, and then we put some ginger, a little bit of ginger, a garlic,
chopped garlic,
and then chive
atau kucai ya. Nah teman-teman di sini biasanya kalau Chinese food atau Asian food menggunakan bawang yang sudah kebanyakan teksturnya sudah di finely chop atau chop yang sudah halus ya teman-teman. Misalkan teman-teman mau masak nasi goreng atau mie goreng, nah di sini teman-teman menghaluskan si bawang ini agar mendapatkan flavor yang aromatik. Nah, withdraw the seed from the chili.
Yeah, withdraw the seed. We don't need the seed.
Yeah.
Because I don't want the seed spoil the looks of the feng chao.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm only using the skin of the chili.
Okay. Nah, teman-teman di sini cabenya tidak pedas ya, karena menggunakan cabe yang besar, tidak menggunakan cabe keriting atau cabe rawit. Ini untuk nanti agak flavor nge-punch aja gitu siap ya, biar nanti dia ada little bit spicy gitu, tapi enggak strong banget. Nah, gitu.
Nah, so already explode ya.
Yeah, explode the chicken feet.
Be careful if you scared of the hot oil here.
Yeah.
You can see.
Ya. Kalau kita punya bahasanya meletup-meletup mungkin.
Yeah. Just be careful. You can use the cover to cover it. But the cover also you must be careful as well, because it will preserve the humidity, the humid, the water, yeah. That will drip back to the oil.
Okay, be careful. Then will
become another explosion.
Yeah, yeah. So the cover is dry and not adding the some water. Okay.
Yeah, only will be safe when the chicken feet is already dry.
Already dry.
Yeah.
Like before fried, you can use the.
It's a battle.
Yeah.
It's a battle between you and the chicken feet.
Battle beginning. Okay. Nah. So you slice the chili. Okay.
Just roughly put it back.
Chili.
And then ginger. The ginger.
Just slice.
Yeah.
For flavoring ya, siapa?
For flavoring.
Nah, ya. Untuk aroma ya teman-teman ya, bagaimana si?
Not too much.
Jahenya di slice panjang-panjang.
Yeah. Gitu. And then chive
atau kucai. Ini di slice-nya besar-besar aja juga. Gitu. Oke. Nah ini teman-teman makanya kalau di rumah ingin memasak usahakan. Bagaimana preparean? Nah itu sangat penting ya teman-teman supaya nanti ketika teman-teman mulai memasak bahan yang teman-teman butuhkan itu sudah siap ada di cooking table teman-teman semuanya. Makanya we must have a good preparation.
Yeah. Anyway, this dim sum, this kind of dim sum, you can actually make in the beginning and then. You preserve in a chiller or freezer. Mm. Yeah, especially the feng chao. The feng chao you can cook first until really cook. After you mix with the sauce, you put in the plastic bag, vacuum it, and then you store in the freezer. Yeah. Can last for 3 months.
3 months in the freezer, siapa ya?
In the freezer.
Okay.
Okay. Well, if you want to reheat, use the steamer. Put use in the steamer. Bamboo steamer like this.
Yeah, bamboo steamer.
Put in the bamboo steamer. Just press a plate or bowl here,
and
then you steam for maybe 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Yeah.
Oke, teman-teman, jadi bisa membuat atau mempersiapkan.
Also, it also give you an idea for the business.
The business.
Yeah. Ah. You can create your own frozen dim sum or frozen food. This idea can actually bring you to the business as well.
Okay.
It's very simple. You can maybe vacuum properly, then you sell to the customer in the frozen pack.
Yeah. It's a good idea, Sep.
Yes.
For building your own business. Nah, bagaimana teman-teman nanti mau bisnis dimsum, frozen dimsum, atau mungkin yang ready to cook atau ready to eat? Nah, dimsumnya, atau mungkin teman-teman mau bikin all you can eat dimsum gitu. Nah. Berarti teman-teman harus tahu cara penyimpanan serta pembuatan si dim sum tersebut. Nah, based on Pokta bilang tadi, bagaimana dim sum itu bisa disimpan di dalam freezer selama 3 bulan ya. Gitu, oke. Okay. Now,
add garlic.
Is dan siap ya? Di ginger ya?
Iya.
Yeah. Okay, put on the back. Nah, di sini we use the wrap.
This one is red rice yeast.
Red rice yeast.
Yeah, atau we soak in the hot water for 10 minutes, and then we remove the water a little bit. Then we smash it with a spoon.
Spoon. Okay. Yeah. It's for coloring the chicken feet, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now the chef strain the water from the rice red yeast.
Nah, yes. Fresh smash like it. This.
Okay. Karena kak ini untuk warna merahnya itu sangat coloring dan munculnya sangat bagus ya untuk pembuatan si chicken feet dim sum ini.
Yeah.
Nah, teman-teman di rumah bisa melihat warna merahnya warna alami, Chef ya. Nah,
yeah.
Nanti this will combine to the sauce, Chef ya.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
Just mash it like this. Mm-hmm. Very simple, easy. Or you can after that you can store it in the chiller or freezer.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime you want to take one teaspoon of the paste, you just take it.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't need to soak in the water anymore.
Just mix it sampai dia halus ya, teman-teman ya.
Yeah, like a paste, yeah.
Like a paste, yeah.
Yeah, you don't need a blender. Actually, if you make a large amount of the paste, then you can use the blender to make it. easier for
based
you.
Based on the quantity, yes.
Yeah, it's only one tablespoon, then use the tablespoon okay. Enough already.
It's already smooth.
Yeah.
Okay. How about the chicken feet, chef?
The chicken feet is almost done.
Almost done.
Yes, okay. It's already floating, as you can see.
Yeah. Nah, teman-teman bisa dilihat tuh.
The color.
Color.
It's browning already.
Nah. Ini nanti bakal di. Yeah.
You see the actually the size is only shrinking ya.
Yeah.
Shrinking.
Menciut ya.
Yeah. Shrinking.
Menciut.
Nah, this one you need to soak around 30 to 45 minutes to make it large again.
Yeah.
Back to.
Or the chicken feet will be puff, yes, okay?
Very puffy, yes.
Yeah, very puffy after the soaking in the vinegar and water.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I think it's enough.
It's enough. Okay. The chef strain the chicken feet. Nah, ini disaring dulu teman-teman supaya tidak terlalu oily atau terlalu berminyak. Nah, ditaruh di bowl yang sudah disiapkan. Oke. Okay. Jadi teman-teman kalau sering makan chicken feet yang ada di dimsum-dimsum atau tempat-tempat yang menyediakan dimsum, mungkin sudah tahu rasanya. Nah, di sini kita kasih tahu bagaimana cara pembuatannya biar teman-teman lebih mengenal lagi apa sih itu Chinese breakfast. Nah, oke, okay. After that put in the
okay. Then straight to the water.
Nah, ini teman-teman bisa lihat sudah ditaruh di dalam air.
Yeah. Leave it for 30 to 45 minutes until the color change and then the skin actually loose from the bone.
From the bone. Okay.
Yes.
Biar lebih empuk ya, Chef, ya.
Yeah.
Mm.
We leave it for 30 minutes and then
we have the already after chicken-nya. Oke. Okay. Nah, teman-teman di sini kita sudah punya chicken feet yang after soaking atau sudah direndam, tekstur dan warna serta ininya
okay.
Berubah ya.
This the chicken feet that already soaked for 40 minutes.
40 minutes.
You see the size? If you can compare?
Yeah. It's different have a different size ya. Yeah?
Look,
nah.
So much bigger, right?
Bigger than chicken feet before soaking, Chef, ya?
Yeah, so much bigger.
It's after and it's before.
Yeah.
Okay, what the next step?
Of the next step, yeah? Yes, of course the sauce.
The sauce.
Yeah.
We combine the sauce, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, we have two methods here. First, I want to fry the shallots and the shallots and the ginger.
Oh, so this chive, chili and ginger should be cooking first, yes, okay?
Yeah, I want to make the taste comes out from the ingredients.
Okay. Jadi di sini teman-teman untuk mengeluarkan flavor dari si jahe, dari
I prepare the water first.
Oh, water. Dari jahe serta kucai dan cabai merahnya, ini harus ditumis dulu ya teman-teman ya. Yeah. Bagaimana proses masak ini juga bertujuan mengeluarkan rasa dari cabai serta si jahenya tersebut.
Yeah.
Oke. Sudah panas.
Ginger first.
Oke.
Takes longer to cook than not easy to burn.
Yeah.
But always take care of the flame of the heat ya.
Yeah. Diperhatikan bagaimana suhu apinya jangan sampai bening ya. Itu nanti takutnya jahenya pahit bisa digunain gitu.
Oke. Okay. Put it low heat, and then
apinya kecil aja teman-teman ya untuk menumisnya.
Some garlic.
Nah, chop garlic. Ini sangat aromatik menggunakan garlic yang sudah dicop. Tuh. Nah biasanya teman-teman di sini kalau memasak menggunakan chop garlic atau jahe, nah perhatikan apinya, jangan terlalu besar juga, cukup di low heat aja atau yang api kecil, biar flavornya dia mengeluarkan sendiri gitu.
And chili and the chive together.
Oh, the next chili and chive. Ini langsung di stir, aduk-aduk. Nah, di sini nanti kita menggunakan.
Give me the oyster
for his sauce. Ya.
Okay, oyster sauce.
Oyster sauce. Nah, ini teman-teman, why we use the oyster first? For the caramelized or for the?
For the caramelized. The flavor of the oyster comes out first.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, as I said in the beginning, right?
Yeah.
The oyster actually doesn't make the your dish smelly. It's not smelly. By oyster itself, but the oyster sauce actually makes your ingredients originally or naturally come out.
Come out, okay. Yeah. Ini makanya teman-teman ya, saus tiram capandanya ini kita tumis terlebih dahulu biar mengeluarkan aroma
dan water
aroma-aroma yang lebih tasty lagi nanti rasanya gitu. So, the chef adding the water, menambahkan sedikit air untuk nanti ada liquid agar basah sausnya ya.
You can add more water, doesn't matter.
Okay.
It's okay. And then one teaspoon.
We put the angkak ya.
One teaspoon of angkak.
One teaspoon of angkak. Nah ini angkaknya sudah diberi taruh di itunya.
And then
the second sauce, save using the barbecue or char siu from the kamki ya. Nah ini barbecue sendiri rasanya ada yang gurih, rasa gurih, asin serta a little bit sweet. Okay. How many spoon you put the barbecue?
This one because half portion, so half I put portion. One teaspoon.
One teaspoon. Okay, yeah. Teman-teman, jadi satu and sendok teh ya teman-teman ya.
Hoisin.
Hoisin. Nah, ini hoisin juga rasanya ada gurih, asin dan sama juga little bit sweet. One teaspoon also, Chef, ya?
One teaspoon.
And soy sauce.
You can always adjust the flavor. Okay. If you want to make it a little bit salty, then you can add a little bit more of premium sauce. Yeah. If you want to make it a little bit sweet, you can add sugar.
Sugar.
Yes.
Or plum, maybe, Chef, ya?
Or plum, yes, of course. You can make it with plum. Don't worry.
Tadi seperti kita bilang ya teman-teman ya, jika sudah menggunakan Likamki produk, kita tidak perlu menggunakan MSG serta
star anise.
Kita juga menambahkan sedikit rempah-rempah, itu ada star anise atau melawang. Nah ini
and
more pepper ya. Oke. Tambahkan, nah, teman-teman harus diperhatikan ya kadar saus-sausnya gitu supaya tidak terlalu asin. Nah, penggunaan sausnya itu harus sedikit demi sedikit, jangan terlalu banyak ya teman-teman ya. Gitu. Oke. Okay. Nah, teman-teman juga bisa nih setelah sausnya dipakai itu kan nanti ada sisa ya teman-temannya, itu bisa penyimpanan agar tahan lama setelah dipakai saus dari Likamkinya itu dibersihkan pinggir-pinggirnya dan disimpan di dalam chiller ya teman-teman ya. Gitu. So the chef is taste the sauce. Is it good, chef?
Very nice.
Very nice. Wow, enak banget teman-teman. Aromanya di sini udah kecium banget nih. Bau sausnya itu udah smells good. Wah, enak banget nih pokoknya.
And then this one.
Okay.
Put it in the sauce mixture.
Sauce mixture, okay. Nah, teman-teman di sini bisa menaruh si chicken feet-nya yang sudah tadi disoaking dalam air dan cuka dalam saus. Nah, okay. Nah ini bisa langsung diaduk-aduk sampai semuanya tercampur rata, Chef ya?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you
then let it the chicken still the sauce is dissolve.
Dissolve.
yeah, with the chicken feet.
Okay. Or a little bit reduce ya, Chef?
Yeah, we reduce the liquid, ya. Yeah.
A little bit reduce. Okay. How long usually you cook this in the pan? 20 or maybe?
Depends. Quantity of the water, okay. The water of okay. The liquid. If you have a lot of, for example, 10 kilos of chicken feet, maybe 1 hour?
Yeah, one hour.
This one maybe 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Ini text time-nya atau proses pemasakannya itu dapat 5 menit aja ya. Gitu. Jadi tidak terlalu lama, tidak terlalu ini supaya nanti kita proses pematangannya di bambu steam-nya. Gitu teman-teman ya. Kita masak dulu sampai dia sedikit reduce atau berkurang liquid-nya. Si chicken feet-nya ini. Oke. Nah ini sampai dia.
Oke. Okay. I think we should move to the second menu.
While we're getting the chicken feet ya.
Yeah.
We next to the our second dish. Nah. We have what?
Okay, I think, we're making a siomai.
Siomai.
Siomai, exactly. I think okay. The chicken first.
Nah, teman-teman di sini kita membuat siomainya atau membuat dumplingnya menggunakan produk atau skin dari Happy Belly ini, teman-teman ya. Nah, ini bisa saya lihatkan. Nah, Happy Belly ini itu. Kalian bisa lihat. Nah, kalau teman-teman di sini biasa mungkin di sini tulisannya gyoza skin. Emang benar biasanya digunakan untuk gyoza skin, tapi nanti kita akan membuat menggunakan isian dari dumpling atau siomay. Jadi teman-teman ini bisa dibeli, ada di supermarket, juga dibeli dengan harga yang sangat cukup murah ya teman-teman ya. Di sini ukuran 300 gram, 10 kali 10 cm diameternya. So we have a chicken and the shrimp. Nah.
Yeah. Second one is siomay.
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 Siomay here.
We can call it siomay, siomay, but originally it's siomay.
Yeah.
Okay. Use the chicken thigh.
Chicken thigh.
Chicken thigh. Chicken thigh boneless.
Nah. Why are you using the chicken thigh, Chef?
I like it juicy, man.
Juicy from
yeah,
the...
Yeah, I don't like the... My siomay is dry. I want to make it juicy. All right?
But if you using breast... some people
you can mix, but not all breast. You not can mix breast. With the chicken thigh,
okay.
Half.
Oh,
yeah.
Some
people they don't really like chicken breast.
Chicken breast,
but
yeah.
They also can taste the juiciness from the chicken thigh. So okay. You have to mix it.
Mm.
You have to mix it, okay?
Nah,
and then you also use the prawn.
Okay.
This prawn you can buy any kind of prawn you want. This one is tiger prawn.
With the medium size.
You can use the frozen one or you can use the medium or small one, doesn't matter. But for me, the bigger one is better because I want the meat is, you know,
yeah.
The bigger the size is,
yeah.
The okay. Better the taste is. Right?
It's good. Maybe.
All right.
Teman-teman bisa di rumah menggunakan okay. Paha ya.
Use untuk your juicy. Food processor.
Processor.
Yeah. This one.
Nah,
or you can call it a chopper or blender, whatever
or
you call
anything
it.
Else.
But remember, if you have a blender in your house, the blender size, the chamber is actually very, very small.
Very small.
So don't add too much chicken to it. Otherwise, the bottom side is blended. The top side is still there. Not blend proper. Not blend evenly. You know. Then it will cause the difference of texture. It will make your texture is spoiled, you know.
Okay.
So use the chopper better.
Nah teman-teman okay. Di sini biasanya kalau chopper yang di rumah agak kecil atau gimana, nah itu harus diperhatikan ya,
if
jangan semuanya langsung.
If you use the small blender, you cut first, cut into small piece. To make it your blender easy to blend.
To blend ya. Yeah?
But if you have this kind of chopper,
no need.
Just put it.
Just put it. Okay. Nah, tips juga tuh teman-teman. Jadi jangan langsung ditaruh kalau untuk small blender ya. Potong-potong dulu. Nah, ditaruh ini.
Oke.
Okay. Oke, okay, we blend it. Oke. Okay. So, chef, the texture is very smooth or
rough? I want it very rough.
Oh, very rough.
Oke.
Okay. Oke. Okay. Ini dituin dulu ya. Di blender, jangan terlalu halus ya teman-teman ya. Nah ini masih agak sedikit tekstur, nanti biar teman-teman pas makan dimsum atau siomaynya nanti tidak terlalu halus banget gitu. Ada tekstur yang bisa dirasakan oleh teman-teman semuanya. Nah tadi seperti chef bilang, kita menggunakan paha ayam agar dagingnya itu lebih juicy dan juga lebih tasty gitu. Tapi teman-teman bisa combine dengan si dada ayam yang sudah file gitu. Nah, ini sudah di blend ya, chef ya?
Ya.
Dia terlalu halus.
This rough texture. This is the perfect texture.
Jadi tidak terlalu halus banget.
Ya.
Yeah. Dia terlalu kasar.
Not too fine.
Ya.
Okay.
So we put in the bowl next.
Okay. Put in the bowl first.
Untuk udangnya sendiri teman-teman menggunakan sini medium size dari tiger prawn. Nah teman-teman di rumah bisa menggunakan udang-udang kecil nanti untuk dalam penggunaan dimsumnya. Oke.
Okay. I leave a little bit for chicken dumpling.
Chicken dumpling.
Use the same texture, same chicken.
Oke.
Okay. Oke.
So
very easy. Okay. I need a scale. Get me a scale. Help me.
Okay.
Get me the scale.
Nah, di sini chef-nya Chef Okta sedang menimbang ya. How many gram, chef?
I need it around 500.
500. Okay. More.
Oke.
Okay. Ini 500 gram ayam yang sudah digiling ya teman-teman ya.
Iya. Yeah. Oke, okay, 500 gram. The prawn, you can use it later.
Ya. Yeah.
This one actually you can, no need to blend.
No need to blend.
Just roughly cut. Oke, okay? I give you around 200 gram.
Oke. Okay. Jadi teman-teman di sini udangnya tidak perlu di blender, hanya nanti di small cut ya, chef. Yeah,
small
cut atau di tidak dicincang tapi dipotong kecil-kecil aja. Itu.
Oke.
Okay. Is 200. Oke. Okay. Remove the tail first. Nah, ini udangnya udah dibersihin teman-teman ya, dari kepala sampai punggungnya gitu. I will take care of the chicken feet ya, chef ya.
Yeah. Yeah, then you must remove the tail and the head. Otherwise, dangerous for your siomai.
Nah, teman-teman di sini chef-nya sedang membersihkan si udangnya dari buntutnya.
It's already been clean ya.
Ya.
Yeah. We already remove the tail and also the shells.
Nah, teman-teman di sini mungkin bisa melihat chicken feet-nya sudah meresap sausnya, warna kemerahannya sudah dicampur. Yeah. It's blend to the chicken feet.
Okay, look at it.
Okay.
I give you nearer.
Nearer.
Okay. Ooh. Right.
Look the color and the smells good from here.
Yeah.
It's
I think more you cook? Can switch off.
Switch off.
It's already. It's already been 5 minutes or 10 minutes, I think. So it's enough. All right. The prawn. Just chop like this. Not need precise, but you need to cut it just rough like this. Any question you can write on board, and then I will answer you at the end of the session. Yeah. All right. Yes.
Okay. Oh ya, teman-teman di rumah bisa bertanya juga during the demo. Ada yang ingin ditanyakan tentang produk Likamki atau okay. Green or Step.
The measurement.
Nah, di sini kita menggunakan lagi-lagi saus tiram capanda.
Yeah. Tea 3 tablespoon of oyster sauce.
Nah, 3 sendok makan teman-teman ya. Nah, sini juga chef-nya menggunakan spoon agar takaran nanti pas ya chef ya.
Yes.
For the good test using the 3 tablespoon of oyster sauce.
And then sesame oil.
Sesame oil. Using the pure sesame oil. The purple one. Okay. 2 tablespoon, siap ya?
2 tablespoon.
Okay.
Correct. Some pepper around 1 teaspoon.
1 teaspoon. And sprinkle. Atau ditaburi saja. Nah ini teman-teman bisa dilihat. Nah, ini nanti kita aduk rata bersama bahan-bahan lainnya lagi.
And some scallion.
Nah ini scallion or leek. Slicing aja. Nanti ditambahkan. Biar nanti ada flavor wanginya dari baun bawang nih. Oke. Okay. Oke. Okay. Put on the bowl.
Not too much, just one stalk of scallion
or chive,
and then soy sauce.
Soy sauce.
Yeah.
We're adding the soy sauce into the bowl. One tablespoon. Nah, teman-teman diperhatikan ya. Tadi step-stepnya berapa banyaknya digunakan saus Likamki-nya supaya nanti teman-teman bisa mencoba di rumah gitu. Nah, we have egg white.
Egg white, you can separate from one piece of egg, ya.
Yeah? Ini teman-teman menggunakan egg white supaya nanti rasanya itu tidak terlalu tough, dia masih agak lembut. Nah, ini untuk melembutkan fungsinya sih, ya. Nah.
And then one and half teaspoon of sugar.
Nah, 1.5 teaspoon atau sendok teh untuk balance si rasanya ini. Gimana nanti tidak terlalu asin melulu, jadi kita tambahkan something sweet untuk si mixture dindangnya ini.
And then we have starch.
Starch, ya.
Yeah. You can use it from the cornstarch.
Cornstarch. Nah, ini kita menambahkan tepung supaya untuk ada struktur
one,
atau
two, kombinasinya. 4
ya.
5
wedding more starch ya here. Ini supaya building the structure ya, siapa?
And then mix
the
slowly
Ini harus diaduk rata teman-teman supaya nanti rasanya tidak ada yang berbeda. Jadi semuanya hampir sama rata diaduk. Oke. Diaduk ini sampai dia menyatu semuanya. Oke.
For the skin of the siomai, you can use any kind of siomai skin,
siomai skin
from the market.
Yeah.
But today we are using the Happy Valley, the gyoza
skin.
Gyoza skin.
Yeah. So chef, maybe audience using the medium floor, is it fine? Or something floor other type of floor? Medium or mungkin potato starch.
You can use the tapioca.
Tapioca. Okay. Yeah. Jadi teman-teman bisa menggunakan tapioca.
Gitu. Tapioca, corn, potato starch, also potato can.
Okay.
As long it's a starch.
Starch ya.
Yeah.
Nah teman-teman tuh bisa menggunakan tepung-tepung lainnya di samping ada tapioca, ada corn starch dan potato starch.
Okay. Leave it maybe for 5 minutes.
Nah, untuk ditinggalkan dulu teman-teman ya supaya nanti bumbunya itu lebih meresap ke dalam adonan daging ayamnya dan teman-teman lebih enjoy nanti menikmati saus dari Lee Kam Ki-nya ini. Selesai?
Oke.
Okay.
And then we mix the dumpling.
Dumpling. Yeah. Nah, teman-teman di sini kita langsung membuat isian dumplingnya. Nah, nanti teman-teman mungkin lebih mau tahu nih bagaimana cara melipat dumplingnya atau cara mengisi siomaynya seperti apa. Nah, makanya nanti kita buat dulu semua filling atau isiannya supaya nanti teman-teman lebih enjoy nontonnya. Tinggal bagian part melipatnya itu yang sangat menarik teman-teman. Oke? Okay? So, okay. We
this one around 200 yeah. to 250 gram.
Using the same chicken ya? Yeah?
The same chicken.
The same chicken.
Yeah.
Nah, dari satu adonan ayam itu bisa dibuat
correct,
bisa di-separate two mixture from atau two filling for the siomay and dumpling. Okay.
Garlic.
Pasti garlic. It's gone. Wah, it's hiding. Nah, teman-teman di sini
this one 250 gram ya, around 250 gram.
Oke. Okay. 1 teaspoon.
2
oh, teaspoon.
2 teaspoon.
Oke. Okay. 2 teaspoon of minced garlic.
It's garlic. And then some chives.
We use more chive for the dumpling. Nah, ini teman-teman ini juga chive ini juga membantu ada aroma supaya nanti dia pas kita makan enjoyable juga. Ada aroma-aroma dari chive. Nah, ini kita slicing aja. Nanti kita taruh di bowl yang sudah terisi dan ayam dan bawang putihnya. Oke. Okay.
Okay, you can use a lot of different kind of filling. Yeah.
Yeah.
You can put cabbage. You can add mushroom.
Okay.
You can add some fish and
some
vegetable, carrot.
Okay.
Beans. Yeah. Everything you can add, or even you can change the chicken to beef.
To beef.
Or pork.
Okay. Or pork.
Yeah. As the flavor, you can create yourself.
Yeah.
But the thing use Lee Kam Ki for the seasoning.
Seasoning.
Yes.
Absolutely, chef.
Absolutely.
Don't forget using the Lee Kam Ki for the seasoning. Nah, itu keywordnya dari Chef Okta. Bagaimana kita menggunakan variety of Lee Kam Ki sauce di sini untuk seasoning. Tidak perlu tambah garam, tidak perlu menggunakan MSG lagi.
Yeah.
So, chef.
Handa brand, as always.
Yeah.
3 teaspoon.
The same seasoning here. 3 essential of Lee Kam Ki, oyster, Okay.
One tablespoon of sesame oil. One teaspoon of
soy sauce. Premium soy. We're using the premium sauce here, okay?
Yeah. Some pepper. And sugar.
Sugar also. Nah, ini sudah di racik-racik ya teman-teman ya. Si isian dari dumplingnya. Okay.
And we mix.
Nah, ini kalau dilihat-lihat we have same ingredients ya, siap ya. For two dishes siuma and dumpling.
Nah, that's what we call it, the three
essential of sauce.
Nah. Oyster sauce, soy sauce, and sesame oil.
Ya, yeah. Nah teman-teman di sini bisa dilihat. Nah tadi kita hanya menggunakan sauces Likamki ya untuk proses seasoning atau bumbui dari isiannya. Nah, nggak perlu menambahkan MSG atau garam lagi. Kita hanya menambahkan lada dan gula untuk balancing dari rasa dari saus-saus Likamki tersebut. Nah, teman-teman kalau nanti mau bisnis or mau usaha entrepreneur, nah ini bisa jadi concern gimana teman-teman bisa menggunakan saus yang sama untuk tiga dish yang berbeda. Gitu.
Okay, we clean up.
Teman-teman kalau ada yang mau bertanya atau mungkin bingung step-stepnya, ada yang terlewat atau mau nanya bagaimana nih chef, kalau saya mau bikin ini, mau bikin itu, boleh aja gitu. Ya, jangan ragu-ragu, jangan malu-malu, langsung aja tanya. Kami berdua siap menjawab di sini, oke? Okay? Nah, di sini ada part yang menarik nih, interesting part chef ya. We holding the skin.
Yeah. Nah. You can use a gyoza skin.
Gyoza skin. We use five maybe.
In Indonesia, wet market?
Wet market.
It's easy to find the kulit pangsit.
Kulit pangsit. Nah, yeah. Teman-teman bisa menggunakan wonton kulit pangsit.
Skin.
Wonton skin atau gyoza skin. Itu teman-teman boleh aja menggunakan kulit. Terserah teman-teman di rumah menggunakan apa aja, oke? Okay? Tapi di sini kita menggunakan gyoza skin from Happy Belly, siap ya?
Yeah. Nah. Sukanda also sell the...
Yeah. The Happy Belly. Ya. Di sini termasuk produk dari Sukanda juga.
This one very elastic. Not easy to break ya.
Ini juga ukurannya 10x10 ya teman-teman ya. Ada sekitar 50 pieces dalam satu pack. Jadi ini tidak terlalu besar, tidak terlalu kecil. I think is the good for
proper size.
Proper size for the dumpling and siomay. Oke. Okay. And nah teman-teman di sini bisa diperhatikan nih nanti Chef Okta bagaimana cara melipat serta membuat siomaynya.
The dump siomay first I think.
Siomay first, oke.
Okay. Leave it aside.
Oke, okay, ini. I will help you Chef ya.
Yeah. You just help me to explain. No need this one.
Oh, okay.
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 The mixture.
Dan teman-teman bisa melihat ini ya, si dagingnya ini.
The scale of the mixer is 30 gram.
Nah biasanya isiannya kalau ditimbang itu 30 gram ya teman-teman ya. Yeah.
30 gram.
Nah ini bisa, ini karena chef-nya sudah ahli, jadi tidak perlu pakai timbangan.
My hand says scale.
Ya. Yeah.
Okay.
You have a good instinct, okay? For the...
Use your finger like this.
Okay. Jadi teman-teman membulatkan jarinya. Using the spoon,
oke, okay.
taruh di bulat jari teman-teman.
First, I think you have to fold it like this. Sorry, okay.
For beginner,
make it a flower.
Nah, dibuat make bunga nih, dibuat seperti lipatan bunga nih teman-teman ya. Yeah. Oke, okay.
Then you hold
lagi,
you hold like this,
ditekan, terus.
Then you flatten the top.
Diratakan atasnya, supaya menyebar ke sisi-sisi kulit dumplingnya.
Flatten the top.
Oke. Okay. Diratakan ya teman-teman ya.
Alright.
Woo. Okay. It's good. Then.
Then. You pop the bottom.
The bottom of the skin ya.
You tap the bottom.
Ya. Yeah. Ratakan juga ya teman-teman ya. Di bawahnya tuh diratakan juga.
Remember
tuh.
Always hold the neck of the shumai.
Oke. Okay.
ya. Do not overpress, otherwise it will be pops up. Oke.
Okay? Jadi di kulitnya ditekan tapi tidak terlalu keras atau terlalu kencang supaya nanti isinya tidak keluar kemana-mana ya.
Exactly. I use show my steamer.
Oke. Okay. Yeah. Nah di sini bisa lihat teman-teman ya. Maybe you can show the camera. Like this.
And this.
Teman, wah, very beautiful. Oke.
Okay. Then you can use a tobiko, orange tobiko as a topping.
Yeah. Usually we using the
grated carrot. You can use carrot or you can use any kind of scallion, mushroom, everything.
Okay, teman-teman jadi bisa menambahkan topping di atas siomaynya nih teman-teman nih. Jadi biasanya kita sering jumpai itu wortel yang sudah diparut atau mungkin ada kucai atau chive atau daun bawang. Nah, ini ya the second time.
Okay.
We show you how to holding the siomay. Bisa lihat teman-teman. Nah, ini dibentuk bunga dulu, make the flower shape.
Okay.
Ya.
Yeah.
Hold. Hold the neck. Then flatten the top.
Flatten the top.
Diratakan teman-teman ya. Diratakan sampai dia separate ke sisi-sisi lainnya. Oke. Okay. Diratakan.
Tap the bottom.
Tap the bottom. Nah. Wow, itu sangat cantik, Chef. It's very beautiful.
Oke. Okay.
Still siomay?
Yeah, I make it two more.
Okay. Nah, maybe we can get the 20 or 25.
For this amount,
yeah.
At least you can make 20.
20?
20.
20.
Yeah.
Oke, okay. Teman-teman. Jadi dari resep yang tadi Chef Okta buat dengan takaran 500 is it?
500 gram of chicken. Of
chicken yang sudah di ground atau sudah dihaluskan, itu bisa dapat sekitar 20 pieces siomay. Nah, yes. Bayangin teman-teman itu kalau teman-teman beli jadi siomaynya tuh mungkin sekitar cuma dapat 4, cuma dapat 5. Nah, better teman-teman apalagi lagi masih masa pandemi, teman-teman buat di rumah aja nih. Make your own dim sum gitu. Jadi bisa kreatif, bisa tambah pengetahuan juga. Belajar bikin siomaynya gitu. Atau bisa jadi bisnis bagus ini. Nah, the last of siomay. Nah, teman-teman masih perhatikan kan? Takut teman-teman di rumah ada yang ngantuk nih ngelihat chef-nya membuat siomay ini. Oke. Okay.
You can try at home.
Yes.
Right now, it's easy.
Oke. Okay. Mungkin sambil nonton sambil langsung praktekin ya, gitu. Oke, okay, the last siomay. Put and flatten the top. Tap the bottom. Okay, and put the bamboo steamer. Then last touch, put the tobiko on top. Okay. Bisa menggunakan wortel, daun bawang atau lain-lainnya ya.
Okay. All right, let's steam.
Okay. Ini langsung di steam ya teman-teman ya. Langsung di steam. Nah ini sambil saya menyiapkan steamerannya. Teman-teman bisa melihat. Nah, sudah di steam. Nah ini teman-teman harus menyiapkan kukusannya. Supaya nanti proses pemasakan atau pematangan di si steamernya ini langsung cepat ya. Oke. Okay. Nah, ini bisa dilihat. Oke.
Okay. Oke, okay, you also can steam the feng chao.
Feng chao, oke.
Okay. Yeah.
I will take care of the feng chao ya.
use the this one also can. Put the lettuce. Mana lettuce?
Okay.
Okay, you can add some lettuce for the base.
Nah, di sini chef menggunakan head lettuce ya teman-teman ya untuk underliner menyetim si chicken feet-nya.
Okay, then add the chicken feet.
Nah, teman-teman bisa lihat kan chicken feet-nya sudah berwarna merah. Sudah coloringnya sudah keluar. Nah ini terlihat seperti yang ada di restoran ya teman-teman nih.
Yes. Oh.
Jadi kalau teman-teman bisa buat sendiri, kenapa harus beli gitu? Jadi better you make.
If you like chicken feet, then yeah. you do this one. If you don't like chicken feet, you also can make something else from the maybe wings.
Yeah, wings.
But wings are different ya. Yeah? Not the method
the process is different, different ya. Jadi kalau pakai wings mungkin prosesnya berbeda gitu. Tapi bumbunya kita menggunakan tentunya bumbu dari Lee Kam Kee.
Alright.
Saus dari Lee Kam Kee. Okay. The chef steam the chicken feet here. How long chef we steam the?
10 minutes. 5 to 10 minutes.
5 to 10 minutes. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Okay. Now we fold the dumpling.
Now dumpling. Third, this is dumpling. Okay, dumpling here. Ya teman-teman mungkin sudah ada yang belajar tentang membuat dimsum atau membuat dumpling gyoza gitu. Nah di sini kita kasih lagi atau kita review lagi bagaimana cara membuatnya.
Okay, same skin
from Happy Belly gyoza skin.
Then round 1 teaspoon.
One teaspoon.
One teaspoon of chicken mixture.
Okay.
Okay.
Ini lebih sedikit ya teman-teman ya, ketimbang si.
Then some egg wash.
Egg wash. Nah teman-teman di sini tadi dari putih telur yang dipakai, ada kuningnya yang tidak terpakai ya. Nah itu bisa dicampur dengan air untuk melipatnya.
Then you fold it half like this.
Ini dilipat lagi teman-teman.
Fold again. Sip it.
Tara, the beautiful dumpling are made. Janet, keren banget siapa? Ya? It's cool. Okay. We can
use. No, we don't steam it with the.
Okay, I'm for it. Nah, di sini kita tidak mengkukus ya teman-teman ya. We don't need to
but
steam
with,
the.
We fry. A little bit, and then we put water.
Nah, teman-teman di sini, it's a same method. Of for gyoza chef ya?
Still same method.
Yeah.
Still. It is gyoza. Gyoza only the Japanese terminology dumpling, yeah. For the dumpling yeah. In Japan.
Oke, okay, jadi di sini nanti di pensir sebentar untuk dapat coloring yang brown. Nah, nanti dikasih air langsung nanti di proses pematangannya langsung di panci tersebut. Oke. Okay. Folding okay. Then
Press. Tap, and done.
More gyoza. Nah. So far belum ada pertanyaan dari teman-teman Binus mungkin? Belum ada? Oke. Teman-teman jangan malu ya untuk bertanya tentang sesi ini.
Chef Aldi will answer everything.
Ya. Dan teman-teman kalau nanti mau coba atau mau membeli saus dari Lee Kam Kee ini, kita sudah tersedia di e-commerce, ada di supermarket, ada di traditional market juga ada, kita punya. Nah teman-teman langsung aja mungkin mau coba bikin dumpling sendiri nih abis nonton ini, apalagi besoknya weekend kan. Nah coba-coba nih bikin chicken dumpling atau mungkin bikin siomay sendiri. Nah, langsung aja, jangan ragu-ragu. Explore kreativitasnya. Di masa pandemi ini kan mungkin teman-teman jarang ada yang keluar ya, gitu.
I think it's enough.
Enough?
Because we already have the spare.
Spare, oke. Okay. Oke, teman-teman, di sini dumplingnya kita akan buat. The chef will pour the little bit oil for pensir the gyoza or dumpling. Nah, teman-teman di sini bisa melihat gimana proses memasakan dari dumpling tersebut. Oke.
Okay. Use medium heat ya. Medium heat. You can put on the pan like this.
I prepare the water for you.
Nah, teman-teman di sini bisa langsung dilihat. Nah, chef-nya sudah mempensir. Ini looking for the color supaya nanti dia agak browning kulitnya. Kan colornya bagus. Nah, biasanya no color no flavor. Nah, biasanya kita harus benar-benar memasak dengan baik supaya colornya keluar. Nah, di sini chef menggunakan medium heat ya, chef ya.
Medium
using
heat. Using
the medium heat. Nah. Teman-teman di pan yang sebesar ini langsung bisa memasak sekitar 9 atau 10 gyoza atau si dumpling ini. Ini ditambahkan lagi. Flavoring-nya bagus.
Yes, one more.
One more. Wow.
Low heat ya, remember low heat.
Low heat, oke.
Okay. Okay, check the dim sum.
Oh,
it's hot.
I think it's cook. More?
One more, one. Two more minutes.
Two more minutes, okay. Nah teman-teman boleh nih, jangan sekali lagi kalau mau bertanya, mungkin ada yang kelewat stepnya atau bertanya tentang produk Lee Kam Kee, teman-teman bisa langsung aja tanya.
It already looks, has the color. Yeah. If you can see the color like this.
Beautiful color.
Yeah, golden brown.
Golden brown.
Okay. And then it's okay to add some water.
Some water. Okay.
Okay.
Nah, ini ditambahkan air, oke, okay. Supaya dia lebih cepat matangnya.
To steam.
Ya, steam langsung di pan-nya ya teman-teman ya. Ini proses masakannya, jadi langsung matang di dalam pan. Biasanya kalau yang siomay dan chicken feet using the bamboo steamer, oke. Okay.
Okay. Okay, I will do the plating after this.
Okay, we clean it up. Nah, jadi ini tips juga teman-teman, jika nanti teman-teman masak atau mau plating sesuatu, pastikan cooking table teman-teman bersih dulu, clean as you go. Nah, itu biasa tuh kalau di kitchen ada kata-kata atau biasanya ditempel di tembok-tembok. Nah, ini kita praktekkan bagaimana harus bersih dulu supaya nanti teman-teman kalau mau plating, kalau mau menggarnis, menghias itu sudah enak tuh. Nah, chef bring the plate. Oke, okay, the small plate. Nah. Nah, ini sambil kita menunggu gyoza, chicken feet atau siomay yang matang. Teman-teman boleh bertanya mungkin atau berdiskusi tentang pembuatan atau tentang produk Lee Kamki-nya nih teman-teman. Nah, jadi kita bahas lagi ya. Sepertinya ada pertanyaan. Ada notifikasinya. Ada. Oke. Okay. We have a question from Yuda Pratama. Tuh.
Gimana?
Oke. Okay.
Chef, saya ingin bertanya, penyimpanan di dalam freezer yang lebih baik adalah setelah kita sudah steam dimsum terlebih dahulu atau pada saat mentah atau belum di steam, kita masukkan ke freezer baru kita steam saat ingin digunakan, atau keduanya adalah sama baiknya, Chef, agar kualitas dimsumnya tetap terjaga. Terima kasih. Oke. Okay. Okay. Jadi intinya disimpan di dalam kulkas atau freezer, baik sebelum di steam dan sesudah di steam, ada plus minusnya.
Ada plus minusnya.
Ya. Kalau if your dim sum being steam first,
yeah,
then the good point is you already kill the bacteria.
Kill the bacteria.
Right?
Okay.
You already kill the bacteria, then after you keep it, you keep in the freezer, it will last longer than the fresh one.
The fresh one before we cook, ya?
Yeah, before we cook.
Before we
Because
cook.
Once you thaw the chicken, you thaw the shrimp.
The shrimp
already in the room temperature. Of course, when you put back in the freezer, it will last lesser than the cooked one.
Okay.
But you only can win with the texture.
Mm-hmm.
The texture, it's still there.
Okay.
You know, the texture, it doesn't change. Yeah. There's a plus and minus.
Oh, okay.
But the thing is, as long as you can keep clean your product.
Okay.
Then it's okay to do the before the steaming.
Okay.
Okay. Before the steaming, you also can do. But after the steaming, you also can do. But for me, I don't want to take the risk.
Yeah.
I rather keep my business goals as a plan, you know, I better steam first.
Steam first.
Yeah.
Okay.
For me,
okay.
Steam first. I want my product sell fast.
Okay.
So I don't want to keep for 1 year, 2 years.
2 years.
So I want to sell fast. So I want to make it easy for the customer to eat.
Nah, teman-teman di rumah tadi untuk Yuda Pratama. Nah, ini Chef Kokta already explain ada plus minusnya, di mana si dimsum atau si siomay ini kita masak terlebih dahulu baru disimpan, atau dibuat dulu baru disimpan. Nah, Chef Kokta lebih prefer ke dimasak terlebih dahulu baru disimpan. Nah, itu lebih lama lagi. Dan bakterinya sudah mati. Nah, tapi ketika kita membuat lalu kita simpan, nah itu kita harus keep clean the ingredients supaya nanti bahannya lebih tahan lama serta teksturnya lebih ada gitu. Semoga menjawab ya, Mas Yuda Pratama. Oh ya, ini ada dari Freddy. Nah, Chef, saya ingin bertanya, apakah ada tips atau cara membuat kulit siomay yang mudah, tidak sulit bagi pemula? Terima kasih, Chef. Gitu. Oh, Mr. Freddy asked to Chef how to make our own skin siomay, Chef.
Yeah, I will explain. Wait.
Yeah. Artinya bisa aja ya si siomaynya dibuat sendiri. Nanti Chef Okta will be explain to you, to Mr. Freddy. Nah, nanti akan ini ya. After garnishing. Oke. Okay. Nah, sambil kita menunggu ya. Gitu.
Okay, I need a moment to answer because I'm still doing the plating. Minta plate yang bulat satu dong. Sorry. Oh. Ah, kurang gede, kurang besar. Yang besar agak saya gede gini. So this chicken dumpling. Show you the bottom side. Very nice color, brown. Okay. This how you serve the chicken dumpling. Flip. You flip back. Flip. Oops. Be careful, eh? It's not always come very nice.
You can rearrange lagi, dibentuk lagi, teman-teman.
Yeah, you can rearrange.
Apa-apa. Ini mungkin nanti teman-teman nggak selalu begitu. Mungkin satu persatu gitu. Kalau susah ya, nanti di rumah bisa ditata lebih cantik lagi. Nah, ini dumplingnya sudah jadi. Teman-teman bisa lihat warnanya golden brown. Crispiness-nya juga dapet. Smooth, masih ada smooth-nya juga. Nah, di sini teman-teman bisa lihat. Oke. Okay. Kasih chive ya biar cantik. Itu.
For the dipping, actually I want to make the very nice dipping. Very easy. Using the soy sauce.
Okay.
And then ginger and sesame oil.
Sesame oil. Nah, ini ada cocolan ya teman-teman atau saus pendampingnya. Nah, biasanya kita buatnya apa sih, Chef? Gitu biasa. Kalau siomay atau dumpling makannya pakai chili sauce atau tomat. Yeah. Nah, ini kita bikin yang sangat simpel menggunakan
saus dari kamki. I want to grate the
ginger.
Ginger.
Yeah. Yeah. Ini diparut ya. Supaya dia dapat tekstur yang halus, tidak di slice ya. We grated the ginger. Oke. Okay. Ini teman-teman bisa menggunakan satu ruas jari dari jahe, tidak terlalu banyak. Kita parut supaya ada aroma jahenya nanti ketika kita dipping atau makan si siomaynya dengan cocolan sausnya ya.
Oke.
Oke.
You can put some chive.
Ya. Dipotong besar-besar aja ya, teman-teman ya.
Yeah. Up to you.
Yeah.
For me, I want to really bite the chive.
Yeah.
Okay.
Teman-teman bisa mungkin di slice kecil. Some soy sauce. Ini mungkin satu sendok makan ya.
Yeah. And then sesame oil.
Sesame oil. Satu sendok teh aja.
Yeah. Mix it.
Dan diaduk, aduk terus.
If you have a black vinegar, you can add a little bit of black vinegar.
Okay.
Yeah. If you don't have, then never mind. This one is already nice.
Nah, teman-teman bisa menambahkan cuka hitam atau
a little bit sugar.
Sugar untuk balancing rasanya. Yeah. Supaya tidak terlalu savory banget. Oke, stir.
Alright. This is it.
Already. Nah, chef, tadi to answer the Mr. Freddy questions, how to make the our own skin? Nah.
Our own skin.
Yeah.
Our own skin. Yeah. Okay, let me answer
maybe
to that.
The ingredients, yeah. Okay. Mention the ingredients.
Alright, it's actually based on the wet flour.
Wet flour.
Water.
Water.
Eggs.
Eggs.
Salt.
Salt.
That's all.
Let's combine.
And combine together with the right compositioning, yeah. Mm-hmm. I will share to you by email later, because I don't remember the. The Grammation
and stuff. Yeah.
So I will email. What's the name of you? Janice?
Mr. Freddy.
Oh, Mr. Freddy. Okay, gitu. Mr. Freddy.
Okay. Okay, jadi teman-teman.
I will forward to you the how to make the shumai skin by yourself. Actually easy. You just how to make a pasta dough actually.
Mm.
It's quite the same.
Same with pasta dough ya?
Quite the same. But only... this one less egg, but pasta more eggs.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, jadi perbedaannya mungkin hampir sama dengan ingredients untuk membuat pasta, ya kayak ravioli atau tortellini.
Yeah.
Gitu. Tapi kalau pasta, dia banyak menggunakan telur, terutama egg yolk. Kalau si skin dumpling ini atau siomaynya less egg gitu, jadi tidak terlalu banyak memakan telur. Nah, untuk teman-teman nanti yang khususnya Mr. Freddy nanti bisa dikasih resepnya ya, Chef.
You can
give the Mr. Freddy recipe.
I'll give it to you by Ibu Farah.
Ibu Farah, by Ibu Farah, oke. Then dari Valencia Janis, Chef, saya mau tanya untuk dumpling bolehkah ditambah udang dan cornstarch? Dan untuk siomay jika dipakai cornstarch dan tapioka rasanya berbeda tidak? Gitu.
Untuk dumpling boleh ditambah udang dan cornstarch.
Nah, oh tadi.
Oh ya ya ya. Okay.
Doesn't use the cornstarch for the dumpling filling.
Yes, you can. But dumpling is actually I want the texture. Actually, you can use the starch to hold the texture. You know.
Untuk.
Because without the starch, the texture will break. Especially when you put some of the fats inside, then you mix together, then there will breaks after you steam it, right? If you put starch, it will hold the texture.
Okay.
Of course, it's better, but the texture is tougher.
Tougher, yeah.
Then, yeah. For me, I like the dumpling. When I eat it, it breaks. With the juice, with the fat, with the sauce, everything melts in my mouth, right? Then, if you want to put starch, it's okay. It's nothing wrong and right in cooking, okay? Just do as you wish, okay? If you want to put the cornstarch or you want to use the tapioca, it doesn't change the flavor.
Okay.
The starch is only hold the texture.
Yeah.
Yeah? To balance the texture. You want to make it... a little bit stiff, then you put starch any kind of starch. You can use the cornstarch, you can use the potato starch, you can use the tapioca starch.
Yeah.
You can use
like
any
you
of them.
Before, Chef, yeah?
Yeah.
We can use any starch. You can use corn or tapioca or maybe potato. Nah, itu nggak apa-apa, teman-teman. Jadi, kalau teman-teman menggunakan starch yang berbeda, itu hanya ingin membuat si adonan ini ada strukturnya. Jadi, dia merekatkan si fatnya dengan
dagingnya
itu. Dan nanti rasanya dia steady dengan ini. Jadi tidak hancur seperti yang gyoza, karena si dumpling ini doesn't using the starch-nya. Jadi saya prefer kalau makan dumpling tuh lebih yang more
juicy
ya. Yeah. Gitu.
Melt in your mouth.
Melt ya gitu. Jadi enggak ada perbedaan teman-teman atau merubah rasa tidak sama sekali ya.
Nope.
Doesn't change the taste ya.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anything you can use of but remember when you use prawns, the prawns for me I think you better chop it chop not too fine.
Like brunoa or dice.
It's very hard to brunoa the shrimp, you know.
Okay.
Okay. The shrimp you just chop roughly. Or just chop tak then yeah. You mix with the chicken mince, then you mix it. That's
okay.
It. You don't need to blend together with the, I think, nothing. Because it will lose the texture of the prawns. Because prawns is easy to what is it? The texture is different than the others, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. So you have to be careful when you do with the prawns, especially. I think I rather to chop it rough. Then the blender.
Okay. Nah, itu teman-teman.
Okay.
Jadi
I hope it answer to all of you. Anything if you have any other questions, you can drop the comments and question by your lecturer here and we can deliver the answer to you right away.
Oh, we can share the recipe also, Chef, ya?
Yeah, after that we can share the recipe as well completely with the instruction.
Yeah.
And hopefully you all enjoy the video today. Event and see you next time. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Gerah gue pakai ini.